Thank you. You guys are such a very quiet and attentive audience. Man, maybe my etiquette spiel was a little too strict. I'm really sorry if I put anybody on edge, but I like it. It's okay. Next up is going to be the Bryan Chamber Strings, and they have three selections for you this evening. We're going to start with Andante Festivo, which is by Sibelius, a nationalistic composer, and he actually wrote this. And I'm feeling like I'm going to mess this up, but I think I've got this right. For Finland, he was Finnish. And so he wrote this as his country's national anthem, basically. The second piece you're going to hear, we're going to stay over in Europe, and we're going to actually play John Williams's Schindler's List, the main theme. And that is going to be by our senior soloist, Mr. Alex Dolan. And then we're going to finish with a very lively and upbeat piece, and it's titled Dia de los Muertos, and that is by Richard Meyer. This is your Bryan Chamber Strings.
Thank you.
Now that we've got the very lyrical and saddening portion of the performance for the chamber strings out of the way, we're gonna lift your spirits a little bit. Now I know the Day of the Dead is, what is that, November 1st? Something like that? It's like Halloween part two. But anyways, it takes place in November, but I'll tell you what, it almost sounds like it should be Cinco de Mayo. And I know I might be upsetting Senora Massey. If she were here right now, she would probably not be very thrilled with me, but I think it's very uplifting. And I feel like it's more of a Cinco de Mayo type, but nevertheless, this is Dia de los Muertos. Feel free to dance along.
Thank you.
feel better now. That first piece was America's Cup, a very, very driving and a very, very rhythmic piece, compound meter piece by Alan Silva. I decided a few months back that I wanted to challenge these guys and give them Class A repertoire to prepare for next year. So if anybody knows me, I'm always thinking at least 2 years in advance. And I wanted to press and push this group so we can go back to Class A status, hopefully next year. And I think that they're off to a great start because this piece and our next piece are both on the Class A list. And I think we're off to a fantastic start so far. The next piece that you're gonna listen to this evening is titled Korobushka. And you're like, what in the devil is Korobushka? Besides the fact that it sounds Russian. And you're right, it is Russian. And it is actually, it is a Russian dance. And in points in the piece, you're actually gonna hear like this Russian tango. Just go with me on that. It sounds like a Russian tango, but it's also the theme in a very popular, or was popular, and still might be popular video game. Do we have any fans of Tetris in the house tonight? If you don't remember Tetris, then man, I am really old. But it's the one with like all the shapes that fall, and you have to like fill them in and all that, and then you have to like match the colors. And anyways, the music from Tetris, the opening theme, is Korobushka. So without further ado, this is Korobushka. Thank you. Thank you very much. We're going to continue on in our program. That was a workout. All right. Burnt my calories today. All right. Next up is going to be a very, very, very popular Coldplay tune within the last 5 years or so. I believe it was on the album Milo Xyloto. It's actually A Sky Full of Stars. Very, very, very driving song from Coldplay in their most recent years. In the past, we've done Viva La Vida. We may have done Yellow. I think we've done something else by them. But this is A Sky Full of Stars. Next up on our indie rock adventure this evening is a song that just came out, I believe, within the last year, maybe just a little over a year, by an artist by the name of Vance Joy. And I'm sure a lot of you have heard it on the radio. It's very, very super popular, Riptide. He's had other hits like Fire in the Flood. I know there's a few other ones, but I think to date, this is probably his most popular by far. So this is our rendition of Riptide. They're working really hard tonight. Let's give them another round of applause. This is indeed the hardest working high school orchestra west of I-75. That's not what you guys got that, okay? Because yeah, we're about the only orchestra west of 75. All right. Before we take a break and go into awards and our traditional senior slideshow, we've got one more piece to perform before we take a little break in the musical entertainment. Most recently, we lost an icon. We lost Prince. Very, very, very unfortunate. And Prince definitely changed the landscape of pop music, funk, R&B. I mean, like we could say with Michael Jackson, Prince was that and probably a lot more, I feel, because he was a heck of a guitarist as well. And I think a lot of people don't realize that by the fact that even though he had like the Jerry Curl and he had the really high-pitched voice and everything too, and he had a little red Corvette and all that, but he was a heck of a guitarist too. And he self-taught himself as well, which was most impressive. We have a small tribute to Prince, and we could have done Purple Rain, we could have done all of that, but it would have taken a lot of time and preparation, and not trying to say we don't want to work hard, but there are really big bodies of work. So instead, we're going to do a hit from the 80s, that is Let's Go Crazy. And this guy back here in the very back, who hasn't been recognized yet this evening, who's been beating away on his bass drum and playing the drum set, that would be AJ Kittle, who is one of our senior band members. Who I've had the privilege of working with for the last 3 years that I've been in Bryan, and whoever is going to be taking his place here in the fall and next school year, he has got some awfully huge shoes to fill because he is just absolutely outstanding. So,
what's that?
13. Size 13? Okay. Well, we've got all summer now. I'll start my search. So without further ado, this is Let's Go Crazy. All right, we've entered that part of the concert where we have to give out some awards. So if I could ask Mrs. Miller and Miss Kuhn, my lovely assistants, to come forward, because my arms are really sore right now. I'm not even gonna lie, and I'm sorry if I'm a whiner, but my arms need a little bit of a rest. So we have some awards to give out this evening. And before we give out those awards, I have some thank yous that I need to give or to mention and to give out. And I'd like to start with one of the most important people in the house, and that would be Mr. Ken Reeker, who is running lights and sound this evening. So, Ken, would you mind coming down? Is it safe to leave the pit back there? And I'm also going to give Eric Hermans to you as well, because these two guys have to deal with Ben Lupo and myself throughout the entire year to make us look so awesome. And video. And Ben and I kind of dropped the ball being so busy and everything. I know, really lame excuse, but we forgot to get a hold of Ken and Eric for this last round of concerts. And so he said that this summer we have to sit down and have the talk. I think we're going to be put on an improvement plan, unfortunately. So, but on behalf of the orchestra and myself, we'd like to thank the both of you guys for all that you do for us. Is Mr. Chris Stopp in the house? No, he's not. Oh. He told me he was coming, though. He must have left already. Well, I'm very sad. Well, Chris is our custodian over here at the Arts and Ed, and he maintains our facilities and does a fantastic job. He is a jack of all trades around here, and if anything is loose or squeaky or needs painted, I mean, he's on it like yesterday, basically. And he is just absolutely phenomenal. So even though he's not here, let's give him a round of applause. Danny Humbarger. Where is Danny at? Oh, he's cowering over there. I'd like Danny to go ahead and come on up. Danny has been working with the high school basses this year. We had two pretty much new basses and Zach Strauss and Liz Holbrook in the back, and Danny's been coming in Tuesdays throughout the entire year, and even other days as well, and has been working with our basses. He also works with our middle school students privately. Actually, last week he just did a sectional with some of our basses, and he's a former Bryan grad. He's an orchestra alum, and he has been absolutely fantastic and valuable to our program. So Danny, on behalf of the orchestra and myself, I'd like to give you this token of our appreciation. I have a couple other thank yous, and I wish I had more thank you cards and everything, but there's just too many, so I have to get to those folks later. But there's Vanessa Resendez, who took care of our decorations this evening, and the lights on the stage. She did an absolutely fantastic job. I'd love to give her a round of applause. Heather Teagarden, for putting together our programs this evening, because I certainly know that I'm not anywhere close to being able to put together the kind of programs that she does. So a round of applause for Heather. And I have to thank my wife, because my wife does our senior slideshows, and without her and her patience and her love, it would not even come to be. So I'd like to give a round of applause for my loving wife for putting together this year's slideshow. I'd like to thank you guys for helping me out this evening. And there's going to be more thank yous throughout the evening, but we got to get things rolling here. So without further ado, we have the Orville Cy Daly Summer Music Scholarship. Now, June, would you like to come forward and kind of give us a bit of a description on the scholarship, and we'll announce the winners then. We have two winners that we are going to announce this evening. So without further ado, June Daly Webster.
Well, my husband couldn't be more proud if he heard the orchestra this evening. What a tremendous job you're doing. It's wonderful. Okay, Cy Daly, that's a long time ago now. We came to Bryan in 1951, and after several years, we had two people in the orchestra who were very, very interested in helping other students. And so Dean and Mary Louise Grove, Dr. Dean, decided to start a scholarship for summer experience for the orchestra. And it has continued all these years. They're just fantastic for supporting it. And I think this year, Paige, could you tell us about the...
Dean and Mary Grove, who live out in the Seattle area. I mean, this is really pretty amazing that they fund this scholarship every year. for $250. But he came to us several years ago and he said if we get the scholarship in by a certain point in the year, we could have matching funds. So this year we have two $250 scholarships and the other money came from the Boeing Foundation or Boeing Corporation. So it's really neat that they have done this all these years. We're very thankful.
I think without further ado, we can announce our 2016 Orville Cy Daly Summer Music Scholarship winners. They are seventh grader Parker Rosebrook. Is Parker in the audience this evening? Okay, yes he is, I just heard his chair. Parker Rosebrook and junior Bailey Sanders. Congratulations. Next up, we're gonna take care of our first year orchestra members. These are members of the orchestra, freshman members that have been in the orchestra for 1 year at the high school. When I call your name, please come forward and save the applause until the very end. Sloan Brown, Haley Collins, Jacob Fenter, Liana Fisher, McKenna Grube, Ellie Hageman, Caleb Hardy, Elizabeth Holbrook, Mackenzie Mackey, Zach Pittman, Joe Pokornik, Carolyn Rickner, Mariah Schuler, and Hope Snyder.
Your freshman orchestra class.
Next up, we have our second year orchestra members. They have been in the orchestra for 2 years, and when I call their name, they're going to come forward and they're going to get their music or their fine arts letter for their jackets. Caitlin Antigo, Chris Chiaramonte, Kayla Elick, Rachel Perk, Nick Reeker, Jonathan Roberts, Amanda Romez, Zach Strauss, and Whitney Weitrow. Ladies and gentlemen, our second year orchestra members. Our third year orchestra members, they've already received their letter last year, so this year, to accompany their letter on their jacket, they have their third year orchestra pin. When I call your name, please come forward to receive your pin. Morgan Bauer, Chase Cooley, Connor Cooley, Henry DeLeon, Taryn Erickson, Caitlin Kammeyer, Natalie Meyer, and Bailey Sanders. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, our third year orchestra members. My heart started to race because this is the part of the evening that always gets kind of emotional. We're going to recognize seven wonderful individuals, and these are our fourth year, our senior orchestra members. When you come forward, when I call your name, you're going to receive your fourth year plaque. Ooh, thank you, Vanna. And you're also going to receive a carnation. Ooh. So here we go. Tony Castiles, Kennedy Dick, Alexander Dolan, Riley Sabins, Riley Schultz, Asia Schuerk, and Cheyenne Sponsler. And AJ size 13 shoes Kittle. Ladies and gentlemen, our senior orchestra members. All right, at this time we'll have the seniors front and center. So while we get the screen down, it's the white switch, yes. While we work on getting the screen down, I've got to tell you, this was a very special slideshow this year. Not because the pictures are great, not because it looks great, but because of all the adversity that we had to encounter within the last 24 to 36 hours. I've had my laptop since I've been in Bryan for the last 3 years. I've never had a problem with it until yesterday. And it decided to show the spinning wheel of death. For those that use Macs around here, the spinning wheel of death showed up throughout the entire day and evening and through this morning. And it took, like, for example, about 15 minutes just to get into my email. It was so painful. And to try to run the slideshow was even worse. And then this morning, the hard drive crashed completely. I was freaking out that I wasn't even going to have a slideshow, and I was thinking of seven people and probably other people in this auditorium that would probably murder me, which means I would need a head start to get on the road and get out of here. Not even kidding. But thankfully, with the help of Mr. Tom Carnes over at the high school, and with the help of my wife and just lots of other people that prayed, we were able to recover the slideshow, and it is ready for you guys this evening. So without further ado, let's go ahead and fire it up.
Yeah.
I'm not sure why there's no music.
Time for you, time to buy and time to lose. remain. All these places had their moment with lovers and friends. I still can recall. Some are dead and some are living. In my life, I've loved them all. But of all these friends and lovers, there is no one compares with you. And these memories lose their meaning when I think of love as something new. Though I know I'll never lose affection for people and things that went before, I know I'll often stop and think about them. In my life, I love you more.
Ladies and gentlemen, the class of 2016. I must apologize for the technical difficulties, but I think we did okay. So, think you want this?
Hi, I'm Alex Dolan. I'm one of your seniors for this year. If I could just get all of our other seniors to come up here and stand with me. So, where do we start, I guess? Sophomore year, Mr. Gordon stepped in as our director. I think it's been a brief 3 years, but it's gone by very fast. It's been a good ride, and I think just a simple thank you doesn't really suffice. For all you've done for us in the past 3 years, I think just the character building experiences you've really instilled in us. You think that orchestra isn't really a blue collar thing, but some of those rehearsals with Mr. Gordon that go right up until 2:45. Definitely a lot of lessons learned and hard work from you. And I think that we can all say that it's been a very, very memorable 3 years of high school with you and orchestra. And as our token of appreciation, we have a gift here for you. We know your love for coffee, so we have a special little violin mug, and then we have a gift card for, I think, a couple of dates out, nights out for you and the missus. So on behalf of the seniors, I just want to thank you so much for all that you've done for us this past 3 years. Thank you.
You guys are amazing.
Thank you guys so very much.
This is always one of my favorite concerts, but I know it's always one of the longest concerts. But there's one thing we haven't done yet this evening with these seniors, and that is to talk about where they're going once they graduate. And your graduation is when? Is it on the 29th. Wow.
My party's on the 28th.
Oh my goodness. So they don't need to get back up. You've already seen what they look like. You know who they are, but I want you to know where they are going once they get out of Bryan, Ohio. I want to start with Tony Castiles. Tony is going to attend Eastern Michigan, which is the second best school in the MAC. And she is going to major in early childhood education. And her parents are Teresa and Anthony Castiles. You can applaud this. Kennedy Dick is going to attend The Ohio State University, the second best school in the Big Ten. where she will major in industrial design, and her parents are Kevin Dick and Kathy Scribner. Alexander Dolan. I have to say that with like some grit, man. Alex is going to attend the U.S. Military Academy at West Point. He is going to be a political science major, and he is the son of Lori and the late Thomas Dolan. Riley Savins is attending the Bowling Green State University, the number one school in the MAC. She is undecided at this point, but will be eating plenty of Poly Eyes in her days at Bowling Green. And if you don't know Poly Eyes, you are missing out. She is the daughter of Ben and Carly Savins. Riley the Terminator Schultz will be attending the Cleveland Institute of Art this fall with an intended major of biomedical art. Her parents are Michael and Shelley Schultz. Asia Shewart is attending the Bowling Green State University, still the number one school in the MAC, where she will major in sports management. And she is the daughter of Sandy Burns. Cheyenne Sponsler will be attending the University of Toledo, the number three school in the MAC. No, I'm kidding. Number two. And will be majoring in math education. She is the daughter of Linda Irvin and Mark Sponsler. Lida Irvin. I'm so sorry.
You're welcome, Mom.
Sorry, Mom. My apologies. AJ Kittle, our drummer. Not Paige Anderson, but AJ Kittle. Sorry, inside joke.
They got it.
AJ will be attending University of Findlay and will major in theater or operations and logistics. He is the son of Alan and Jamie Kittle and plans to continue his percussion career along with the Go Bears legacy. Next up, we have two more pieces of award things to get out of the way, and I promise we will get back to music making and get out of here this evening. The National School Orchestra Award is the highest honor that can be bestowed on the senior member of the string orchestra program. And it is voted on by the students, not myself. And it's someone who has displayed integrity and leadership and has been like the ultimate cheerleader and the glue that holds the orchestra together. And this year, the 2016 recipient of the National School Orchestra Award is none other than Alex Dolan. Quickly, I am going to call out the members of the Bryan Chamber Strings. I don't want to get out of here this evening without recognizing the Chamber Strings and all their hard work that they have put in this year with performances, with things during the concert season, things outside in the community. I want to make sure that these 13 individuals are recognized. So I'd like to ask Mrs. Miller and Mrs. Kuhn to come up and to help me hand out these awards. When I call your name, please come forward. Morgan Bauer, Chase Cooley, Connor Cooley, Alex Dolan, Kayla Elick, Taryn Erickson, Caitlin Kammeyer, Natalie Meyer, Nick Reeker, Jonathan Roberts, Carolyn Rickner, Bailey Sanders, and Riley Schultz. Sorry. Ladies and gentlemen, the 2015-2016 Brian Chamber Strings. At this time, we are going to go ahead and take the stage, and we are going to set up, and we are going to perform Starlight and Kashmir and wrap up our 2016 Pops concert. So just give us a couple moments, please. This evening is going to be Kashmir, which is by the 70s band Led Zeppelin. They've been known for The Immigrant Song, they've been known for Stairway to Heaven, that's their most popular tune, and several others. But this evening we are going to perform Kashmir, which is, if you've never heard before, is very Middle Eastern sounding. And you're going to hear that, especially in the middle. There's a lot of what we call augmented steps. And augmented steps sound very, very Arabian sounding. So it's going to sound very Middle Eastern. And this evening, we are going to feature Zach Strauss on guitar. When Zach first started an orchestra, Zach was a guitarist. And he's never had any string background until last year and most definitely this year. And he has done a great job picking up a second instrument. And so we are going to feature him on this last piece. On behalf of the orchestra, thank you for coming out this evening, for supporting us, supporting the arts and Brian. And we just hope that you guys have a great evening, have a great summer, and we hope to see you back in the fall. Thank you.
Thank you. One more round of applause for the Bryan High School String Orchestra, please.